All right. Check 1, 2, 3. What's up?
Check 1, 2, 3.
Hey-o. All right.
Super loud?
No, you're good.
Okay.
We're perfect.
A, B, C, D?
Yeah. No, we're good. All right. Awesome. Yeah, and then just during timeouts, we'll just turn ours off quick. I'm letting myself check the Packer game one more time, and then it is all business. I'm going to have that in the back of my mind. Nice. Look at you, just... I get, like, whenever I'm doing... Like, I end up just always forgetting about social media. Like, I know I should do stuff. But
no, you gotta market this type of stuff you're doing.
Yeah.
I feel like a badass.
I don't have Drake following me though, so it doesn't really matter.
I don't get a whole lot of engagement, so don't. I'm not that cool. But I do have random people always messaging me. I have this guy in jail message me and say,
"Go Drake.
Please tell him to follow me. I'm trying to change my life around." It's like, sir?
If you're in jail, why is that?
I don't think Drake's gonna help me.
Why won't you be like, find somebody who like knows the president, message them and be like, "Hey, give me a pardon, I didn't do anything wrong."
But he was a rapper. That's the
thing.
Oh,
well.
And he wasn't a very good one either.
Maybe to turn your life around, don't rap anymore. Anyway.
My main thing was...
Let's do this. Hello, everybody, and welcome inside the Cox Pavilion on a Sunday morning from Las Vegas as we're ready for day two of the 2019 UNLV Lady Rebel Roundup. It is the consolation game to start us off today. UNLV and St. John's with IUPUI and Elon to follow in the championship game. I'm Ben Wilson, joined by former Lady Rebel Amy Calloway, who was gone yesterday enjoying the Thanksgiving holiday. Amy, hope you had a great weekend back home with your family, and thanks for coming out to hang with us today.
I missed you guys.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. I think everybody agrees. We missed you, too. We're looking at a consolation game, though, today, where UNLV now losing by 6 yesterday to Elon. That's now, Amy, the third loss in 4 games by 6 points or less. Another one of those games where they were right in it till the end, but a lot of youth and inexperience that we've talked about a lot this season ended up dooming the Lady Rebels down the stretch as they end up falling by 6.
Yeah, I think with a couple more games, they'll get that experience where hopefully they'll be able to pull out those close games instead of losing by 6 or less.
Well, and now at 1-4, really in desperate need, not necessarily of a win, Amy, but more just a positive performance, something to take into the Mountain West opener, because they take on Fresno State on Tuesday. It'll be the earliest Mountain West opener in team history. How important is that? Just trying to get a little bit of momentum when you come into the start of what really counts, the real season, which is your Mountain West slate.
Yeah, you definitely want to have something positive to hang on to as you go into a basically a new season. So because you have the pre-conference and then conference is a whole new season, so you want to have something to hold on to start off strong.
As for St. John's, losing yesterday 85-78 to IUPUI, it had snapped a 2-game winning streak for Joe Tartamella and the Red Storm. St. John's, pretty experienced team, but they're without one of their 3 preseason All-Big East players in Alicia Cabey. That said, Amy, this is really a matchup of completely opposite teams. St. John's, a team that struggles rebounding. They're the worst rebounding team in the Big East, but a very good 3-point shooting team. They like to get up and down the court. They'll score a lot. It's a fast pace, whereas UNLV obviously much better on the rebounding side, but they've obviously struggled shooting the ball, and they'll try to play a much more slower tempo type game today.
Yeah, another difference that I noticed is free throws. St. John's is definitely a great free throw shooting team, whereas UNLV has struggled a little bit from the line, so we'll see how that pans out in this game.
With St. John's, Alicia Cabey, she's out injured, a preseason All-Big East player who was on the Big East All freshman team a few years ago. She's now a senior, but as a result, a freshman, Emma Nolan, will replace her in the starting lineup for the 4th consecutive game, coming off a game yesterday in which she tied a season high with 12 points. Also for St. John's, I mentioned Tiana England. Kodasha Hoppe, the other preseason All-Big East player, leading the team in 3-point shooting, over 50% on the season, while Alyssa Alston coming off an 18-point game to lead St. John's yesterday. And Kadasia Bailey rounds out the starting 5 for the 8th-year head coach, Joe Tartamella. While for UNLV, starting with Letitia Smith, Caviana Brown, Bailey Thomas, Rajane Wade, and Krista Jackman, the same starting 5 as yesterday. RJ had a big game, just a couple rebounds shy of her 4th double-double in 5 games. 15-8 on 6 of 12 shooting, but did foul out in the final moments. And they will need others besides RJ to step up today, Amy. She was great early, but Elon really adjusted. They doubled and triple-teamed Wade down the stretch, and as a result, she really did struggle. Didn't get a lot of help from her teammates, and we'll see if the Lady Rebels can get a spark from somebody else today. Letitia Smith starts us off and comes up well short. I know for you, Amy, as a former player, you know it's got to be multiple people. It can't be just one over the course of a 40-minute game.
Yeah, once it's one person, then the other team can, like they did yesterday, start doubling, triple-teaming, so that offense gets cut off, and so other people need to step up.
We're just underway, 20 seconds into the game, as Emma Nolan, freshman from Valparaiso, Indiana, steps to the line. Her twin sister, Sophia, is also a freshman on the team, and St. John's get the first point of the morning here on the West Coast, early afternoon back east. St. John's will have a red eye tonight back to New York, where it is snowing, I'm being told, by the St. John's staff. They are keeping track of the weather as it is Two free throws for Emma Nolan after the foul by Bailey Thomas. So we're just underway from the Cox Pavilion. Thanks for spending part of the end of your Thanksgiving weekend with us here through the Mountain West Network and streaming live on at YouTube. Smith lines one up. A little bit too strong. Letitia Smith did struggle yesterday. 5 points after two straight 20-point games in her previous two. And it's 2-0 St. John's. Nolan looks for more, but that three is too strong. And Smith corrals the rebound. Up ahead, there's Wade. Nice play in transition for the Lady Rebels as R.J. Wade gets UNLV on the board. Tied at two just a minute in for Kathy Olivier in her 12th year on the Lady Rebel bench. You have to figure, Amy, games like yesterday, so frustrating for a head coach. They forced 26 Elon turnovers and still could only muster 44 points, losing the game.
I think that's when it comes in where you need someone other than RJ to step up on offense, because I think if a couple other people stepped up, those close games wouldn't have been so close.
Here a foul called on Krista Jackman as, again, Nolan going hard to the rack. Emma Nolan, who did a good job yesterday getting to the foul line, led the team, was 6 of 7 from the charity stripe. And in high school, she was her school's all-time leader in points, rebound, steals, and blocks. And her sister, Sophia, was second all-time in those same categories. So those two combined for almost 4,000 points at Marquette Catholic High School in Valparaiso. And Indiana has actually been a source of several recruits for St. John's, coming from Queens in New York City, with the second free throw good. And it's 3-2 for the Red Storm. All three coming courtesy of the freshman Emma Nolan. A minute and a half into our third place game from the UNLV Lady Rebel Roundup. Again, Ben Wilson joined by Amy Calloway, as it is Brown on the left side. She struggled with foul trouble yesterday, able to find Smith in the paint, and she gets bumped by Emma Nolan with 8:18 to go in the first period.
Looks like St. John's had to apply some early on pressure in the full court right there.
Well, and Nolan, really the only forward on the lineup. It's normally a five guard. I guess Bailey is technically a forward too, but usually a lot of small ball for St. John's as they try to keep the tempo up, force some pressure, turn you over, and capitalize on the three ball. As this pass is a little too high for Caviana Brown, and it goes back to St. John's. 3-2 Red Storm, 8:12 to play in the first quarter. You just wonder too, Amy, it's a consolation game for both teams. You never want to come out of a Thanksgiving tournament empty-handed, and both teams were right in their semifinal games yesterday before losing. It was a tie game for St. John's before they were outscored 21-14 the rest of the way against IUPUI. So a lot on the line. Both have some challenging games coming up. Obviously, like we mentioned, UNLV's Mountain West opener Tuesday. So this is more about getting confidence, right? Just getting back into a positive rhythm if you're both teams.
Yeah, no one wants to come out of a tournament 0-2. St. John's doesn't want to come out on the road 0-2 and go back home to snow and depressing weather in Miami.
Yes.
And then Lady Rebels don't want to come out 0-2 in their own tournament.
Right, it would be a double whammy for St. John's, especially with that red-eye flight tonight. Red Storm with the early 3-2 lead. Hoppy knocks it away right back to Smith. 7:30 to go in our first quarter, just underway from the Cox Pavilion. Third home game in the Cox Pavilion this year for the Lady Rebels after their first two were in the larger Thomas and Mack Arena next door. Thomas too strong on the three, and a rebound for Alyssa Alston coming off that 18-point afternoon yesterday. Nice feed. Nolan draws the foul and can't finish. Good opportunity for an and-one for Emma Nolan, but she goes back to the line for the third time already in this first quarter as it's Smith called for the first personal.
It's nice that you have her coming in replacement for KB, and then she's basically all the offense right now in this current quarter.
Yeah, Emma Nolan was averaging about 17 or so minutes a game, averaging around 4 points, 3.5 boards per game, but with KB out, St. John's and Coach Joe Tardamella needing somebody to fill pretty big shoes. And so far, Nolan's done a great job of that. All 5 points for the Red Storm as UNLV breaks the pressure. Down by three. Smith hard to the tin. Can't finish. And then Wade goes over the back on Nolan. And with 7 minutes even to play, In the first quarter, UNLV has four team fouls already. And Wade, that's something we'll be tracking, her first personal after fouling out yesterday. That's something UNLV, you've, I think, noticed, Amy, has struggled a little bit with, just being too aggressive sometimes on those offensive misses, and they've been prone to those over-the-back fouls.
Yeah, they have to be smart. If they're getting pushed back on that rebound, they're definitely going to get called for that over-the-back, so get trying to get position early on to get to have a fighting chance for those rebounds.
Wade ends up sucking it in. Both Nolan for St. John's and Jackman of UNLV collided as they went for that rebound, and it stays 5-2 St. John's. 6:25 to go in the first quarter. Wade can't get the turnaround, but Smith is able to collect. Nice move on the baseline. She can't finish. Jackman and Wade each have it. And now RJ, after basically taking it away from her teammate, puts it up and in. St. John's coming quickly the other way. That is a charge as Kadesia Bailey crashes into Bailey Thomas. And the redshirt junior, who's been the best defender for the last couple years for UNLV, draws the charge. It's 5-4 St. John's, 6:07 to go, first quarter. You talk about a spark, Amy. Sometimes when you're a defensively minded team, it can be defense that sparks your offense. That's what they're hoping with Bailey Thomas.
Yeah, Bailey Thomas has been really good getting the passing lanes, getting on the floor for loose balls, and definitely has gotten a lot of offense off of her defense.
Wade leaves it short. Jackman can't get the follow. Comes right back to the 6'5 center. Jackman, she goes up strong. That won't go. And now a foul coming inside as Wade was fighting for the ball. And that will go again on the UNLV senior. So two personals in the first 4 minutes and 18 seconds. Not the start for the senior leader that Kathy Olivier was looking for, as she was kind of tangled up there with a couple Red Storm defenders in the paint, and it gets called for the personal. So that brings Haley Rydolch in, and a tough break for UNLV, Amy.
Yeah, those kind of fouls can go either way, and then it sucks when it doesn't go yours. So now she's on the bench with two fouls early on. So hopefully other UNLV players can step up right now.
Jackman also coming off as St. John's able to streak right down the middle. Almost an uncontested layup there for Tiana England, who leads the Big East in assists, is second in steals, and fourth in minutes. She has been a true leader for the Red Storm out of Stamford, Connecticut. And it's 7-4 St. John's. Rydolch gets the answer. Haley Rydolch hasn't been playing a whole lot, but when she's in, Amy, usually shows off a really nice touch, especially on those baseline Jays.
She's a master at that short corner pull-up, I'll tell you.
UNLV wasn't sure where that ball went after the miss by Hoppy, but they collect. We cross the halfway mark in the first quarter. 7-6 St. John's just underway from the Cox Pavilion as Smith gets a high screen from Rydolch. Throws up a floater, but that won't go. Smith is playing with a lot more confidence, being aggressive, coming off the heels of those two 20-point games, but shot won't go there. Now Hoppy can't hit the three either. And the rebound for Rydolch. She and Jackman, the two true centers on the Lady Rebels, only played, they combined 12 minutes yesterday. And here UNLV is called for the 10-second violation. Thomas did not get it across the timeline in the allotted 10 seconds. And with that, it brings us to immediate timeout. 4:30 to go in the first quarter. St. John's 7, UNLV 6. We'll be back with more right after this here on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. The UNLV Pep Band making some noise on this Sunday morning in the desert. 7-6 St. John's over UNLV. We're just underway in our Lady Rebel Roundup consolation game. Ben Wilson back with Amy Calloway. We were talking earlier, Amy, neither of us have worked out much over the last week, like doing physical exercise. I guess that happens when it's Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
but
I definitely ate a lot. Ate most of my body weight.
Respectable. This is the time of year to do it. I did so myself. Nice dinner at the Venetian on Thanksgiving. So, yeah, we're trying to get back into shape here by at least watching some people be athletic as we're back underway in a foul called on Rydalch of UNLV.
There's nothing wrong with living vicariously through all the attacks on the floor.
Exactly. I'm totally with you, Amy. As long as we're on the same page, that is very good. With a busy stretch continuing, it'll really be over after Tuesday in Las Vegas. The rodeo comes to town. If you're not familiar, that takes up almost the entire month of December at neighboring Thomas and Mack. So both the men's and women's teams will be on the road for quite a bit after the Tuesday home game for the Lady Rebels, with both free throws made, and St. John's has a 9-6 lead over UNLV. Leilani Correa, freshman off the bench, hits the throws. Rydalch gets the answer. Haley Rydalch with 5 early points to pace UNLV, and we're tied at 9. The center from St. George, Utah. Here a block inside. Justice Etheridge says no. As UNLV can come the other way, looking for its first lead of the day. 3:50 to play in the first quarter.
There have been a couple of teams who have caught UNLV on that back door, and I'm assuming St. John's probably saw that, but obviously Etheridge has been working on her backdoor defense.
Etheridge has been struggling shooting, but trying to contribute in other ways as Thomas gets stuffed inside. That's Cecilia Holmberg just into the game, and now a travel called as Brown picked it up and then rolled over. So good defense on display the last couple of possessions for both teams.
Yeah, when you're struggling offensively, the least you can do is just make sure the other team doesn't score.
Well, that's been the theme at times for UNLV this season, off to a 1-4 start. St. John's probably understanding a high-scoring team. They'll need to get some stops as well today as England throws up a wild floater that is brought in by Etheridge, and the Las Vegas native can outlet up ahead to Brown. 3:10 to go first quarter, tied at 9. With Bailey Thomas and Justice Etheridge leading things. Etheridge 2 points, just 1 of 9 from the field yesterday. She's been a streaky shooter through her UNLV career, trying to break out of a mini slump. As Rydalch, she has the hot hand right now, but comes up short on the baby hook. Fumbled by Correa, but St. John's gets the run out. Layup too strong for Alston. Followed up and then missed on the second opportunity for the freshman Correa. She gets it back. Can't hit there. Goes up strong again, and this time draws the foul. What a crazy sequence. Leilani Correa had about 3 different looks at the hoop. And it ends up being Anna Blounce called for the foul. 2:37 to go as we get the stoppage. Tied at 9, and Melanie Isbell checking into the game. So Blount picks up the foul, 1 of 5 freshmen who have played a ton for Kathy Olivier. Let me ask you, Amy, you and we all expected a lot of freshmen to play this year for UNLV, but were you expecting this much here in the early going, where you have yesterday 5 freshmen combined for 75 minutes?
You don't expect it early on, but then when you look at the breakdown, how everyone's playing, a lot of the freshmen on the floor aren't playing like normal freshmen. They're not as timid as you usually see. You got a lot of confidence on the floor, even if they may not be hitting or scoring as much. So they're just playing a little bit differently. So that's why I think it's surprising, but not so surprising for this UNLV team.
In the meantime, Correa hits both free throws. Team's leading shooter from the stripe, and it's 11-9 St. John's. Taken away in the backcourt, but a foul called. That is on Alston. Her first personal. And the third team foul on St. John's with 2:34 left in the quarter. Understanding, too, that UNLV already struggling to begin with offensively, Amy, and St. John's has really been trying to pressure the UNLV guards, knowing that if UNLV can get it into the post, they've got a significant size advantage there.
Yeah, it seems like the guards are a little bit shorter and then the posts are a little bit bigger, so they have to use that to their advantage here.
Blount, strong move to the basket, but it's blocked by Correa, then off the freshman Blount. And it goes back to St. John's with 2:14 to play in the quarter. Impressive play by the 6-foot freshman Leilani Correa, who transferred very late in the fall, was enrolled at West Virginia and was supposed to be a Mountaineer this year, but transferred in September, was granted eligibility by the NCAA at St. John's just 4 days before the season opener. But here an offensive foul called off the ball on a moving screen by Sophia Nolan. Actually, that is Emma Nolan, excuse me. Her twin sister is not checked in yet for St. John's. But that will be the second foul on Nolan, who got off to the hot start with the first 5 points for St. John's.
Now picks up two early fouls.
So with Blount and Isabel, two freshmen on the floor for Kathy Olivier, they go back door and cash in. Thomas to Etheridge. That'll get you kick-started if you're Justice Etheridge. She's taken the majority of her shots from three, but able to get some space underneath as Rydolch called for her second personal.
Yeah, she struggled from the three-point line yesterday, so I wonder if we'll see more to-the-basket plays for her, or if we'll see more shooting and making this time.
UNLV over the limit, so free throws for Alyssa Alston. Yeah, you just wonder, too, Amy, for a player like Etheridge, a lot of expectations, the Las Vegas native coming in as a freshman. Coaches were not shy about saying they expected her to take a big leap as a sophomore. Is that tough sometimes mentally when you know what the expectations are and you're in a slump and you're trying to figure out ways to keep your confidence up?
Depends on the player. Some players use that as motivation to get better, and some players it can be a little bit of a mental obstacle for them to get over, but I think Etheridge has the mentality that she's going to get better and she's going to take that and do what she needs to do.
Both free throws good for Alston. I would think it would help. UNLV has one of its special assistants this year, the recent graduate Para Strother, who had to go through kind of the same thing, right, as a local product, and you were very familiar with Paris being a former understanding playing with her and being a teammate. So I'm sure it has probably helped a lot of these Vegas natives to have someone like that to lean on.
Definitely, and there's a couple of Las Vegas natives on the team, whereas I know some teams have only like one local, but there are a couple on UNLV's team and staff with Mia Bell as well. So definitely a great place to be as a Las Vegas local is on this UNLV Lady Rebel team.
Yeah, Isabel, the other Vegas local, as this shot goes for Correa. Leilani Correa, the freshman, in a game featuring a lot of freshmen on the UNLV side, the youngster for the Red Storm heating up, 15-11 St. John's. Isbell looks to cut inside, throws up the teardrop, and gets the friendly roll. Nice play in traffic by Melanie Isbell, who played 26 minutes yesterday.
Isbell is definitely not the tallest player on the floor, but she's not afraid to get in there and go against the taller people on the floor.
Holmberg steps out, can't hit the three, and Jackman corrals the rebound. Final 40 seconds of the first quarter, about 11-second differential, with UNLV down 2, 15-13. Isis Bay into the game, posts up on the right block. Isabel left open, can't hit the three. There's Etheridge for the follow. That one won't go, and St. John's appeared to touch it last. They did. Kadasia Bailey couldn't quite wrap it in. And with the shot clock reset, we'll have a 2.5-second differential with 22.4 to go. And Tiana England back in for the. And we haven't seen Etheridge slash a whole lot to the bucket. It's been a lot of, like you said, Amy, perimeter shooting. So clearly trying to mix things up, get herself more active.
Like I said, I think she's one of those players mentally who's going to take the challenge and figure out ways to score.
Hoppy the steal, but can't finish. Isabel might have just caught the ball on her way by, did just enough. And now UNLV with a potential runout. Etheridge goes down. Isabel with 3 seconds to go. Isabel into the paint, kicks to the corner. Three at the horn is too strong for Bailey Thomas as the first quarter comes to an end. A good battle back and forth by both teams, but it's St. John's on top, 15-13 after 10 minutes of play. We will step aside, be back with more from the 2019 Lady Rebel Roundup right after this here on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. Time for the second quarter inside Cox Pavilion. St. John's up 15-13 on UNLV. I'm Ben Wilson, joined by Amy Calloway on this Sunday morning on the West Coast. Interesting first quarter as St. John's went just 2 of 14 from the floor, Amy, but they were incredibly efficient. 11 of 12 from the foul line, where they've been a very good free throw shooting team like you mentioned so far this year.
Yeah, that might, when it comes down to it, it might be a close game, and we're going to see a lot of good free throw shooting from St. John's.
And with that, it's not the start to the quarter UNLV was looking for with a blocking foul called. St. John's was in the bonus about halfway through the first quarter, and a quick foul picked up 7 seconds into the second quarter on Caviana Brown. Meanwhile, on the UNLV side, 6 of 22 from the field. To start things off, led by Haley Rydolch with 5 points off the bench. So St. John's up by two. Tiana England leading things from the point. One of three preseason All Big East players in the starting lineup for Joe Tartamella, although one of them, Alicia Caby, out injured today. With the shot clock down to two, Bailey has to launch. That three comes up short, and an uncontested board for Krista Jackman, already her sixth today. Jackman struggled yesterday, only got in for 5 minutes despite starting. But the previous game she started it against Duke had 7 rebounds with Bay feeding Jackman. That's a jumper from the free throw line that's too strong. And Cecilia Holmberg, the native of Sweden and true freshman, brings it down for St. John's. A minute in, 15-13 Red Storm. Quadasha Hoppy hasn't gotten loose yet. No points, averaging over 20 a game. As Holmberg steps back, leaves it short, but an offensive board for Bailey. And St. John's resets. That has to be surprising, Amy. 0 of 2 from the field for Hoppy, who's been a tremendous scorer for St. John's. With a foul called again on Brown inside.
Yeah, it looks like UNLV's doing a really good job by limiting her scoring. So St. John's has to pick it up elsewhere, but Nolan has been pretty good for them on the floor so far, so have other people stepping up and place them.
And so two fouls on Brown. She comes out. Cambrea Elsie in, didn't play yesterday, her first DNP of the season, with Kiana Wilford in as well for UNLV. Quick pass to Correa in the paint, can't get the roll, and then Wilfred gets the board for UNLV. 8:25 to go first half, 15-13 St. John's as Elsie brings it up, the 5'7 sophomore. But it's poked away, that is Correa. The 6-foot freshman is blocked but fouled from behind by Etheridge. Doing a lot on both ends, the Manchester, New Jersey native Leilani Correa, a 4-star recruit, who has been tremendous off the bench this year for St. John's.
Yeah, Chris. been stepping it up really good in this game, coming off the bench. Last game, didn't have very many points, but she had 8 rebounds as a guard, which is pretty impressive. And then against UMass, had 11 points and was 50% from the floor. So she's definitely an offensive threat.
Season high, and led the team with 8 boards yesterday. Also 3 steals to lead the way. Has already been named Big East Freshman of the Week once in the early going, and leads all freshmen in the conference in scoring this year, over 11 points a game. She has 8 points, 6 for 6 from the line, as St. John's continues this torrid pace at the stripe, 13 of 14, where they've gotten just 2 made baskets today, but they lead by 4, 17-13. Thomas gets inside, is blocked from behind, but fouled by Holmberg. And with 8:05 to go in the half, Bailey Thomas heads to the free throw line, where yesterday she did a very good job, Amy, of getting to the basket. Only took 1 field goal attempt, missed it, but got all her points at the line yesterday.
Yeah, and this is the first time UNLV's been at the line all game so far, so making it count.
Bailey Thomas, who the coaches were telling us in the preseason, came in right there with Brooke Johnson as far as defensive acumen, but it was all about confidence offensively. And you have to say, Amy, the last few games have seen Bailey Thomas look more aggressive and look for her shot a lot more often.
She definitely has, and she also gotten a lot of stuff generated from her defense, which is the type of player she is. So it's nice to see her keep progressing in these next couple games.
On the other end, though, a burst of speed from Tiana England. Impressive finish for one of the best all-around players in the Big East, the redshirt junior, and it's 19-15 St. John's. Elsie can't hit on the floater, and now a 2-on-1 opportunity. Hoppy brings it up. Nice layoff. There is Holmberg. St. John's with its largest lead. 7:25 to go in the half, and Kathy Olivier calls time with the Red Storm up 6. That was a nifty little pass there. Hoppy barely touched it, but flips it right to Holmberg, who gets the easy finish.
Nice little behind the back there.
I know that impressed you, Amy, the former Lady Rebel.
When you're on the run like that and you can do all those types of things, I can barely pass regularly on the run, so being able to do a little bit extra is always fun to see.
Again, living vicariously. That is our theme today on this Thanksgiving weekend. We'll step aside and be back right after this. St. John's up 6 on UNLV. This is UNLV Basketball on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. .27 to play in the first half, 21-15, St. John's on top of UNLV. We're back on the Mountain West Network. Amy, a St. John's team just 15-16 a year ago, but expectations really high. They were projected to finish 10th, or out of 10 teams, 2nd in the Big East. That's a big deal, a solid basketball conference, as we all know. And for Joe Tardamella, who took over for the winningest head coach in program history, Kim Barnes-Arrico, they are expecting a lot. And with a pretty senior-laden team and experienced-laden team this year.
Yeah, and even their freshmen looked experienced before. You got Nolan and Correa looking like seasoned players.
A block inside. There is Holmberg, another freshman, on the floor. But she catches Krista Jackman on the arm. And so Jackman heads to the line, who's had to play some big minutes. Rajane Wade picked up 2 personals in the first quarter. Kaviana Brown, another one of Kathy Olivier's starters, on the bench with 2. So Jackman is kind of the next post player up after Wade before you get to all the freshmen, and she misses the free throw. So the coach is asking a lot of Krista. She's shown kind of the stereotypical up and down nature from a player new to getting a lot of minutes. She's played in the past, but usually just sparingly. And you've kind of seen flashes early on, Amy, but still just a player trying to put everything all together.
Yeah, it's kind of difficult coming off of maybe a season that you don't really play as much to a lot of expectations, especially as a post player. So we'll see how she kind of molds into herself this season.
She does go 1 of 2 from the line. St. John's by 5. Correa with the drive, gets caught on the baseline, and Thomas right there to pick off the pass. 6:50 to go in the half. Smith up ahead, layup won't go, as it was altered slightly by Sophia Nolan, the twin sister of fellow freshman Emma, and a nice play there by the 6'1 Nolan. Made that a difficult finish for Smith. And it's back to St. John's with 6:44 to go in the half. With Alyssa Alston, started her career at Ole Miss, but a New Haven, Connecticut native who transferred back closer to home. And we'll get to have a homecoming of sorts next week as St. John's heads to Yale on Friday night. 21-16, the Red Storm lead. They've been up most of the way, despite only making 4 field goals. It's been virtually all from the line tonight. I guess this morning. Getting ahead of myself here on this end of this very long and busy Thanksgiving weekend. It's been a lot of fun. Tons of games in the area. Vegas has essentially been tournament central for all these holiday games as Alston looks to drive on Brown. Bounce pass into the paint. Pretty floater up and in for Kadasia Bailey. The Long Beach, New York native, and St. John's extends the lead 23-16. For a 6-foot forward, usually a post player, that is a really impressive finish as Bailey can't get the answer on the other end. Bailey Thomas, that is, with Kadasia Bailey, the rebound for St. John's, and she travels. 5:53 to go in the half, still a 7-point Red Storm lead. And Kadasia Bailey, who was on the Big East All-Freshman team last year, didn't start but was a top backup for Joe Tardamella. And the one thing you notice, even the forwards for St. John's and the post players, Amy, all have really good touch, all good athleticism, and they all are pretty mobile as well.
Yeah, if you look at their stat sheet, their field goal percentages, almost all of them are over 50%. Great free throw shooters all around, not just the guards. So the difference between this UNLV team and St. John's is not being able to score right now, but St. John's using the free throws as advantage.
Anna Blount, though, with a nice shot in the paint, back to a 5-point game. As it's a drive for Alston, Thomas got a piece of her on the way up. And so Bailey Thomas called for her second personal. So now you have Brown, Thomas, and Wade, probably 3 of the most important players, Amy, on this UNLV roster, all in the starting 5, and they all now have 2 personals. As Alston goes to the line and the beat goes on, St. John's understanding right now their advantage, like you said, at the line, where they're 13 of 14 to start. 74% on the season as a team, and Alston has been very solid, 80% in her own right. Went to prep school in Long Island, where she won a prep national title as a sophomore, and goes 2 for 2 here. It's 25-18 St. John's, 5:21 to go in the half. With Unique Drake checking in, another freshman off the bench for the first time for the Red Storm. Something I guess you really do need, though, if you're in the Big East and you want to compete for a title. Really solid in the fundamental parts of the game, and St. John's has been very good in that area so far today as Jackman can't hit. England hesitates, looks for the bounce pass, but throws it right to Elsie. Chance for a 2-on-2. Etheridge up ahead. She can't finish, but able to poke it away. Feeds Elsie. That shot blocked in the paint by Bailey. And now a foul called as UNLV is able to collect in the corner. 4:45 to go in the half. And despite a couple nice defensive plays, Amy, that's kind of the microcosm of how the season has gone in the early going for Kathy Olivier, just unable to finish on the interior after some positive plays defensively.
Yeah, it looks like they're getting to the basket. They're doing what they need to do, but they don't have that soft touch to finish, and they're not getting any fouls called, so they're they're not getting to the free throw line as much as St. John's either. So there's definitely, they need to step it up in one category or another.
There was a couple subs after a foul called on St. John, so it does say stay UNLV possession. One of their last 11, the Lady Rebels from the field. 4:35 to go in the half, trying to chip into a 7-point deficit. LZ gets into the paint. Tough shot. That one won't go, and Correa gets the board. St. John's looks to push. This is the strength of their team, and Drake gets the finish. Unique Drake, a Columbia, South Carolina native, and a 4-star recruit coming into Queens, gets the finish, and the Red Storm have their largest lead of the day, 27-18. And that's what makes it kind of a double whammy for UNLV. Not only are you struggling to hit, but St. John's such a good transition team as well. They can kill you on the misses. That's what the Lady Rebels are looking for more of. Justice Etheridge, the finish. There's the transition game, but Drake can't put it in on the other end. As we go back and forth, St. John's by 7. Blount into the paint. There's the friendly roll. Something the Lady Rebels have been waiting for, the friendly roll off the front of the rim. And now Blount called for the foul, defending Correa. Seems like so many of those similar plays, Amy, have hit the front of the rim and then just rolled out.
Yeah.
And that's not just today. That's been all season so far.
I don't know if you noticed that on that last play, Justice Etheridge with the backdoor cut finish, and she was the first one down the floor to try to block that shot on the other end. So definitely great hustle there by Etheridge.
And she certainly understands. The coaches are expecting a lot out of her. They want her to be more than just a sharp-shooting three-point threat. Coming into the weekend, 28 of her 35 field goal attempts were from long range. So a player who's trying to do a little bit more, and while it hasn't shown up in the box score yet, she's at least given you the effort you're looking for as Correa makes both free throws. 29-22 St. John's, 3:30 to go in the first half. Brown gets to the baseline, tough finish. Actually, that's Smith on the drive. Letitia Smith 0 for her first 6 from the field, but gets the bucket there. UNLV with a couple made baskets in a row, but Correa gets the answer. And there's the back door you were looking at, Amy, that has given UNLV a lot of trouble. As they get the finish with Correa and then a turnover in the backcourt, Isbell and Blount not on the same page. And that will get a sub off the bench. Wilfred in for Blount. You did point out earlier, though, Amy, UNLV, they've done a better job shoring up that backdoor defense, but it's still been something that teams can take advantage of at times.
I'd rather you say at times than the whole
game. Right, better than nothing.
Definitely progression is there.
Correa's pass deflected out of bounds by Smith. If there's any player on the Lady Rebels team who will have the desire and energy wanting to beat St. John's in particular, it's probably Letitia Smith, as we see this ball picked off by Etheridge. She strides to the basket and puts it in. Back to a 5-point game, 2:50 to go in the half as it's 31-26 St. John's.
And that was a smooth, seasoned move by Etheridge right there.
Now another steal. So we'll have to get back to Smith in a moment because Etheridge is the story right now. She gets the steal and draws the foul. Justice Etheridge, who only scored 2 points yesterday, held scoreless last week, but she has done a great job of attacking and now has a team-high 6 points, a chance for more at the line.
Justice Etheridge will be at the free throw line, shooting 2.
With Sophia Nolan called for the foul, 2:37 to go in the half, and St. John's up 31-26. Make it 27. As Etheridge puts it in. She had that tremendous opener, 16 points, 5 boards, tied career highs in all those numbers against Cal State Fullerton, but had struggled since. Leading the way today with 7 points as UNLV's back within 4. Correa lines one up. That's too strong, and Isbell corrals the rebound for the Lady Rebels, looking to push. So Letitia Smith, the former Seton Hall Pirate, that's why I say she has as much motivation as anybody against St. John. She's been in these Big East battles before. Inside to Bay. That will go with a foul. And all of a sudden, UNLV has found it from the floor as they get to within 2.
Really strong post up there, nice finish, and got a foul, so the chance for a three-point play for the freshman.
Gretchen fouls on number five.
Isis Bay played 25 minutes yesterday, got five boards. Has been a great post presence, but has not gotten a whole lot of looks to at least score yet, and that will do a lot for her confidence. Isis Bay with the and one, and it's a one-point game. 31-30 St. John's. England can't get the finish. Correa blocked on the inside by Wilfred, and it's tipped out last by the St. John's freshman with 2:03 to go in the half. UNLV on a 6-0 run over the last minute and a half to get themselves back into this game. And after only scoring 18 points in the first half yesterday, UNLV at the 30 mark. Smith blocked inside by Nolan. That hits the baseline, and it's slashed off Wilfred with 1:49 to go in the half. So if nothing else, Amy, has to give you some confidence now going into the locker room. Yesterday, every basket seemed so hard to come by, and at least today things have opened up a little bit in the second quarter if you're looking at this from a Lady Rebel perspective.
Yes, and if they can keep this energy up for the next minute and 40, they could definitely come out of this half, to a new half, with some newly found energy and hopefully come out with a win here.
There's a friendly roll, though, for Sophia Nolan, and a big answer as Nolan had a foot on the line. It's a two, and it's 34-30 St. John's. Actually, it is a three. Thought initially they ruled two, but it did look to be behind the line. So back to a four-point advantage. Smith on the fallback, and that's a beautiful finish. Slow start for Smith. Starting to heat up now, though. 1:05 to go in the half. 34-32 St. John's as Nolan had that one knocked away by Smith and out of bounds. Also into the game, Shamakia Duncan, a senior from Staten Island who didn't play yesterday, has been mostly a reserve throughout her career for St. John's as that inbounds is knocked away by Wilfred. As we get towards our final minute of the first half and Bailey re-enters, the team's leading field goal shooter for St. John's. Kodasha Hoppe, leading scorer. One of the best in the Big East, second in scoring, but she has not gotten a point today. End of the corner, Correa on the drive. Tough finish right over Wilfred. Leilani Correa continues to impress for St. John's. Red Storm back up four, final 40 seconds of the first half. Just a smooth 6-foot guard who can do everything for St. John's. Smith, that one's nothing but net. And all of a sudden, Letitia Smith, as she's done over the past couple weeks, catching fire. Now a steal by Isbell and a foul called on St. John's Correa. Kind of a bad break there for UNLV because Isis Bay was wide open for the finish. But Correa just decked Letitia Smith after the steal. And with 22.1 to go, UNLV should be heading to the line here, assuming that that foul stands, and we'll see the officials collaborate and decide on the call. Darla Founce, Tiffany Jump conversing right now. Ken Sobey, our other official.
They are, and both players had a chance.
How about that, Amy? 35 first half points for UNLV. That is something that Lady Rebel fans have been waiting to see all season, and they have finally found their stride in the second quarter.
Definitely a nice little rebound from the last game, but it looks like they actually called the foul on Letitia Smith.
Wow, so they overturned the call and end up putting it on Smith. You're exactly right. Second personal. So Smith now the fourth UNLV starter with two fouls, and it allows St. John's to hold for one. And what's been a good up-tempo first half. Red Storm have looked really solid at the line and elsewhere offensively as this ball is knocked away by Smith in the paint. Correa trying the entry for Nolan.
Wilfred has shown a lot of really good defense in these past couple possessions with a lot of deflections there, making it hard for St. John's to do anything.
Correa to inbound with 14 points, 8 of 8 from the field. There's a nice entry, but Bailey gets blocked by Isis Bay. 3 seconds to go in the half. Isabel will have to launch. Instead, it's Smith at the horn, and that one comes up short. A high-paced ending to a first half that started slow. Both teams getting into a nice groove as UNLV ends up closing the half on a pretty big run to get a 7-point deficit down to one. Positives for both teams, Amy, to take into the first half locker room. For St. John's, the leading scorer, Kodasha Hoppy, held scoreless, but they got a huge half from the impressive freshman Leilani Correa to lead the way with 14.
Yeah, you had two freshmen from St. John's, Nolan starting it off and then Correa finishing it off with most of the offense for St. John's. So let's hope both teams come out with this type of energy for the second half.
Meanwhile, for UNLV, things were in a dangerous spot because Ranjanae Wade, who really did everything for them yesterday, picked up her second foul. Letitia Smith and Justice Etheridge, though, really picking up the slack. They each lead the way with 7 points. Haley Rydolch also had five off the bench.
Yeah, Letitia and Justice definitely have picked it up since RJ's been on the bench. Letitia started off a little bit slower, but has hit her last three or four, not including that chunk at the end.
Right.
And then Etheridge coming in with some energy, definitely making sure that RJ is not as missed as she is on the floor.
Really, the stat of the first half, St. John's 17 of 18 from the foul line as the Red Storm lead by one. It's St. John's 36, UNLV 35 as we go to halftime here at the Cox Pavilion in Las Vegas. Consolation game of the Lady Rebel Roundup. We'll take a break. Be back with the second half after this. You are watching the Mountain West Network, streaming live on YouTube. Welcome back inside the Cox Pavilion, just about ready for our second half to get underway. It is the consolation game of the 2019 Lady Rebel Roundup from Las Vegas. St. John's on top of UNLV 36-35. Ben Wilson back alongside Amy Calloway. Really fun first half, Amy, after a slow start for both teams. St. John's kind of got themselves into the game at the free throw line where they were fantastic, 17 of 18 from the stripe. Well, it took a late flurry by the Lady Rebels to get back into the game. Letitia Smith, Justice Etheridge, each with 7 points. Both teams have to feel like they're in a pretty good spot now coming out of the halftime locker room.
Yeah, I think both of them went into halftime with good things on both ends, so we'll see how they come out in the second half. UNLV ended up getting a couple free throws at the end of that half and actually did pretty well, 5 for 7, so hopefully they can keep that going to match up with St. John's.
It is UNLV who starts with the ball as Letitia Smith comes up just short. Chance for St. John's to do what they do best, and that is run with Alyssa Alston getting to the 10 as she scores. 6 points for Alston. She was the team leader yesterday, but Leilani Correa, very impressive freshman with 14 off the bench today, nearing a St. John's career high, had 18 in her freshman debut, which was the most in a debut for anybody in the program since 2004. So Correa's been great. It's a 38-35 St. John's lead. Krista Jackman inside and gets the finish. Jackman was great on the boards in the first half. Her first field goal, a scoop shot from Quadasha Hoppy, is left short as Jackman comes up limping a little bit as she comes down the other end. A minute into the third quarter, 38-37 St. John's. RJ Wade picked up 2 fouls early in the first half. She's backed in and can't draw iron. End of the paint. Bailey finishes right over Bailey Thomas. You would think this pace favors St. John's right now, Amy. Up and down we go.
Notice in the last two plays, Bailey for UNLV has gotten position on both possessions, one altering the shot enough to where she didn't make it and another where she ended up making it, but she's really good at getting down, hustling down, and getting in position.
The foul called on the inside as Brown drove into the paint and Tiana England called for the personal. England, Alston, Nolan, and Holmberg all with 4 personals for St. John's. UNLV had 4 of its 5 starters with 2 fouls. Smith, Brown, Thomas, Wade, as well as Blount off the bench. As we're just underway in the third quarter, 8:28 to go from Cox Pavilion. 40-37 at St. John's, who fell 85-78 yesterday to IUPUI. With this lob coming in to Letitia Smith. Lady Rebels fell 50-44 to Elon. So both teams looking to bounce back in the consolation game today. UNLV 1-4 on the season. St. John's preseason picked to finish 2nd in the Big East, 4-2. And we get a jump ball called here. Alston was able to grab that away from Bailey Thomas, and the arrow gives it back to the Red Storm of St. John's. Now for Alyssa Alston, that was a play right out of Bailey Thomas's defensive playbook there, Amy. Nolan can't hit here, and it's slashed off of Bailey Thomas. And even 2 minutes in to our third quarter. I'm sure Thomas has done that a ton over her career, but usually doesn't have the ball taken away from her like that. Alston out of control. A pass right through the hands of Kadesia Bailey. Lady Rebels with 10 turnovers so far, 9th for St. John's. The big key we tracked coming in, St. John's the worst rebounding team in the Big East, UNLV the best rebounding team in the Mountain West. So far, just a 3-point advantage for UNLV on the glass, which has really helped St. John's keep this lead. Arjanae Wade has it fumbled from her hands down to her shins and out of play, and a UNLV turnover, but it looks like they'll get bailed out. A late foul call going on at St. John's. So take away the turnover for RJ, and it stays UNLV possession. 7:32 to go in the third quarter as it is Alston called for the foul.
Seems like in the last couple of possessions, both teams have been a little bit too antsy with the ball. wanting to score really bad and just end up with turnovers. This one obviously was a foul instead, but.
Taviana Brown on the drive, throws it high off the window and draws contact. We saw UNLV struggle with fouls. They let St. John's get into the bonus early in the first quarter, eventually in the second quarter, but three team fouls on the Red Storm in the first 2.5 minutes.
I'm sure KO in the halftime talk said that they had to get to the line and because St. John's was just shooting off free throws, probably basically saying we have to get to the line too and limit them on the line.
That's a good point. Kathy Olivier, the 12th year head coach. While it's the 8th year head man, Joe Tardamella, on the other side. He's led St. John's to 3 NCAA tournaments, including a second round appearance back in 2014. Here a foul called on Brown after she hit both free throws. 40-39 St. John's, 7:20 to play in the third quarter. And for Brown, that is her third personal. Will quickly come out for Melanie Isbell, who more than doubled her previous season high yesterday, playing 26 minutes. Tiana England on the drive and kick. Wide open three, up and too strong for Bailey. It is Thomas who collects the rebound for UNLV. 3 minutes into the third quarter, Lady Rebels with the ball down one. Trying to get some confidence going into the Mountain West opener on Tuesday. Nice pass, nice move by Wade, but she can't get the finish over Holmberg. And St. John's with a 2-on-1. England takes it herself, but Smith did just enough to alter the shot. And UNLV comes the other way. Thomas wide open for three, but can't hit. It's a board for Jackman. Goes up strong with a baby hook. And UNLV has its first lead since back in the first quarter. And that gets the UNLV bench and fans excited here at the Cox Pavilion with 6:15 to go in the third. Krista Jackman, we've been talking about it throughout the season in the early going, Amy. She has struggled with her touch like a lot of other players. But a nice finish on the inside there. As this will be a foul, I believe, on the floor before that shot attempt. And it will be, yes, two free throws. Actually, no, an inbound. So they say that foul actually before she gathered and went up. After a recollect on the play as Thomas is calling for her third personal. So that's the one thing UNLV will have to track here. Brown and Thomas both now with three. And yet another foul called on the inbounds play. That's on Smith, her third. So with 6:06 to go in the third quarter, Amy, UNLV up one, but three starters now with three personals.
Yeah, definitely not a good way to start the half.
But Smith gets the rebound. It has been positive offensively. UNLV has looked a lot more confident. St. John's scoreless now over the last 3 minutes. 5:45 to go in the third. Wade can't finish. Follows it up, and the persistence pays off for Rajane Wade. 6 points, two boards today for the senior. 43-40 UNLV, 5:35 to go third quarter.
One great thing going for UNLV is even though they may not, the shot may not hit at all at once, they have people to clean up the boards and get that second attempt.
England, though, with the answer. 6 points now for Tiana England, preseason All-Big East player, who is on the Nancy Lieberman preseason award watch list. Wade blocked from behind but fouled by Holmberg. And with UNLV up 43-42, Wade heads to the line.
You see RJ with a lot more aggression going to the paint. I think she's trying to make up for lost time that she spent on the bench in the first half, and she's definitely bringing that energy and hopefully finishing at the line right now.
RJ tied a season high yesterday with 15 points. Has scored 15 in each of the last two for UNLV.
She's been really efficient from the floor also. Last two games, 50% from the floor, rebounding the way she needs to. So I'm glad she's back on the floor in this half.
And I had talked about this yesterday, Amy, while you were still probably in a food coma from Thanksgiving, but RJ 2 of 17 from the floor the first two games. So you're exactly right. That's been a huge turnaround for the Fresno, California native.
But the good thing in those early games when she wasn't finishing on the floor, she was finishing at the free throw line. So that's where she's been consistent in points, but where they've coming from has been different.
She's also worked really hard on her free throw shooting, has improved that a ton this year, leading the team in that metric. Hits both there, but then a foul called on the other end as Sophia Nolan and the Red Storm got behind the defense. Etheridge takes the foul. That is the second on Justice, and it's the fourth team foul. Both teams with four, so we're going to see both in the bonus. As Nolan got behind the defense, laid it off for Kodasha Hoppe. And with 5:09 to go in the third quarter, Hoppe is still looking for her first points of the afternoon. Came into this tournament, Amy, averaging 20.5 per game, second in the Big East.
And free throw percentage at 82, and she missed that first one. We'll see if she hits the second.
That's probably been the biggest surprise of the day today. Hoppe 0-for-2. St. John's was 17 of 18 from the line until those two misses. And as we cross the five-minute mark, you have to say, momentum on the UNLV side. Lady Rebels up 45-42. That pass deflected, comes right to Rydolch as St. John's transitions into his zone. Rydolch, that's her favorite spot on the floor. This time leaves it just short. Etheridge the follow as she lays it for Rydolch, but it's fumbled. Comes right to Correa. 2-on-2 for St. John's. The pull-up won't go. There's an offensive board for Hoppe, and she draws contact on Rydolch. 4:33 to go in the third quarter. And we go to a timeout. UNLV 45, St. John's 42. A tight one developing at the Lady Rebel Roundup in our consolation game. We'll have more from Las Vegas right after this here on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. UNLV on top of St. John's. 4:33 to go in the third quarter as we're back on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. Ben Wilson with Amy Calloway on this Sunday afternoon, wrapping up a very busy Thanksgiving weekend. Right now, St. John's trying to find its rhythm. The Red Storm have struggled from the field, Amy, really the whole day, 32%, but they have gotten their money's worth from the line, 17 of 20, and Kodasha Hoppe goes back there right now. And they'll be in the bonus for the final 4:33 of this third quarter as Hoppe finally gets on the board, the Big East Freshman of the Year, who is just the third ever to win that award in the Red Storm's program history. A local product from Staten Island. Coming off a 35-minute, six-assist outing, both team highs yesterday, as St. John's back to within one, 45-44. Wade into the paint, floater will go, and really that run we saw at the end of the first half, Amy, definitely has carried over into the third quarter for UNLV offensively.
Definitely, they kept the same energy coming into the second half, which is nice to see after you have that 15-minute break.
For a young team like the Lady Rebels, they've really struggled putting together quarters in a row. And four overall quarters combined, just the one win so far. This would be a huge win for Kathy Olivier today if they can hang on, but still a lot of time left. And Leilani Correa going back to the line as Etheridge picks up her third personal. Four Lady Rebels now with three fouls, and you would have to think that's probably the biggest pressing issue, right, for the last 14 minutes and change in this one, Amy, the fact that St. John, such a lethal free throw shooting team, they know exactly how to get their points, and it's right now at the line.
Yeah, and UNLV's in foul trouble, so double whammy there.
Correa approaching a new career high in her first year in Queens with St. John's. Gets both free throws. It's 47-46 UNLV. Four to go in the third quarter. Isabel on the drive. Puts it up. Leaves it short. Wade corrals the board. Goes up strong and earns two free throws. Just snatched that away from Alston, who probably thought she had an easy rebound, but the 6'2 RJ Wade had other ideas.
Snatched the rebound, gathered herself really well, and got the foul there. So great hustle by RJ right there.
And Wade gets the first free throw. She was a fantastic runner in high school on the track and field teams at Edison and Fresno on the 200 and 400 meter relay teams. And that checks out when you watch RJ run the floor. As she misses the second, right off the offensive board and a reset for UNLV, up by two. Right back to Wade, goes with a drop step, is blocked but fouled. Working on the much shorter Tiana England at just 5'7". And so RJ Wade, who was quiet in the first half with those two fouls, 11 points and five boards in 11 minutes.
Like we mentioned before, RJ is one of those players who finds a way to score. If she's not hitting on the floor, she finds a way to get to the line and finishes pretty well at the line. And if she's not finishing at the line, she's finishing on the floor. So very well balanced score.
That one in and out. Rebound for Leilani Correa of St. John's. Red Storm down three, looking for the tie. Hoppy drills it in the corner. It was only a matter of time before Quadasha Hoppy got on track. And the junior hits the three. We're tied at 49, 3:25 to go. Pretty stroke there. She just hasn't had many looks today. Isbell gets the answer with a head nod to boot. Melanie Isbell ties a season high. Second straight game with 5 points for the freshman. Jacinta Buckley into the game, nearly forces a turnover, and we get a tie-up. Kathy Olivier fired up out to almost midcourt as the arrow gives it back to UNLV.
Seems like Mel's MO right now is hitting those threes that change the momentum of the game.
She has found a knack for those shots in the big moments. Just a freshman, but has been thrown into the fire, running the point in crunch time. Will likely, depending on the situation, see that again today. Quick passing comes to Wright Alch, goes with the hook shot, but it's off back iron. Etheridge did just enough with her positioning to force England to knock that out of bounds. And with 2:50 to go in the third quarter, Unique Drake checks in for England with UNLV up 52-49. Both teams in the bonus. Rydalch has been great off the bench. Foot on the line. That deep two is too strong, but Buckley the reset. Back to Wade, who's been the player of the quarter for UNLV, and she draws yet another foul. Going right at the freshman, Sophia Nolan. Brajane Wade, three double-doubles in her first five games. Tied for the conference lead heading into the weekend, leading the Mountain West in rebounding. And puts it in.
I've been really impressed by how RJ's been able to gather herself on certain possessions where in years past I think she would have thrown up a really quick shot that's a little out of control. So she's definitely done a really good job of pacing herself and controlling what she throws up.
One of those things where it's all about the speed of the game, right? When you're on the floor, I'm curious for you, Amy, how that felt when you were a senior compared to your freshman, just how fast the game was playing out in front of you.
Yeah, that transition from high school to college is definitely something different. So once you have a couple years under your belt, you definitely get used to the pace.
Largest lead of the day for UNLV, but it's cut into there on the pretty floater. Kadasia Bailey, tough finish in the paint. It's back to a three-point game, 54-51 UNLV, 2:12 to go in the third. Isbell, the freshman, leading the point. Jacinta Buckley, another one of the seven freshmen, a top 60 class for UNLV, into the game. Buckley working on the freshman Correa for St. John's. Wade draws a double team. Now they back off. Isbell in trouble. Finds Etheridge. Has to heave and does not catch rim. Good defensive possession for St. John's as UNLV was a bit stagnant.
Looks like they missed a couple open passes they could have passed to RJ in the paint. Just were a couple seconds too late.
I don't blame her. Isbell has to get that ball to her.
And it's a three-point game still, 54-51. Bailey thought about the three, now takes it to the cup and scores. Nice move off the dribble for Kadasia Bailey, the 6-foot sophomore. She's had a very smooth game today, 8 points, second high behind Correa. 1-point game with UNLV on top. A near steal by Drake. Etheridge the drive and kick. Wright Alch from 15 knocks it down right in front of the UNLV bench. Quick shot on the other end. That's too strong from Hoppy. Kicked out to Drake. Her three too strong, but Correa's right there. Blocked in the middle by Wade. And here come the Lady Rebels. 2-on-1. Etheridge, that's Wade. That's a layup. And the Lady Rebels lead by 5. The long strides of the 6'2 senior, R.J. Wade, the block on one end. And as you alluded to earlier, Amy, running the floor with confidence on the other end and being ready for that pass coming from Etheridge.
Definitely great when you can see that defensive hustle and then first person down the floor to get that layup.
58-53, UNLV on top, 56.3 to go in the third quarter. We'll keep it here on the Mountain West Network, streaming live on YouTube this afternoon, early afternoon on the West Coast, nearing the 4 o'clock hour back east in New York. As it's St. John's and UNLV, St. John's will stay on the road as they go to Yale next week. But the Red Storm, while they have a fairly experienced group, Amy, they're still working on finishing games off themselves. They were tied yesterday with IUPUI. The Jaguars pulled away late. St. John's blew a 11-point lead in their only other road game, a loss at James Madison a couple weeks ago. So for them, it's still a work in progress, a team that I'm sure it's tough mentally when you go below 500 but come back and have expectations that you can finish in the top two in a Big East that is always so tough top to bottom.
Yeah, trying to switch it around is always probably one of the hardest things. Coming off of a winning season and going into another winning season, but trying to make that turnover is definitely difficult. But we'll see how St. John's does throughout the season.
Had an 11-year postseason appearance streak snapped last year when they went 15-16, 7-11 in the Big East. Would have made the NCAA tournament 6 times in the last 9 years. Here, though, a steal out of the timeout. Letitia Smith catches Alston napping for St. John's. It is a 60-53 UNLV lead. The Lady Rebels, after scoring 44 points yesterday, on pace for 80 this afternoon. And it's been a lot of defense that's led to offense, as you were alluding to earlier, Amy.
Yeah, when both teams are having a little bit of a trouble finishing on the floor, defense definitely makes up for it in most cases.
And St. John's really feeling it now from the field. Haven't gotten to the line nearly as much as they did in the first half, which gave the Red Storm the lead. Just 33% from the floor today, and UNLV's taking advantage. 60-53 Lady Rebels, final 8 seconds of the third quarter. Against the St. John's zone, 5 seconds to go. Isabel to Smith, thought about the three, puts it up with the horn and misses off to the left. As we reach the end of the third quarter, but a big period for UNLV as they outscore St. John's 25-17 in the frame. Final quarter coming up next from the Cox Pavilion here on Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. It's UNLV 60, St. John's 53. We head to the fourth quarter inside Cox Pavilion. UNLV with a big third period to take a 7-point lead over the Red Storm of St. John's. Ben Wilson back from Las Vegas, joined by Amy Calloway as we wrap up a fun Thanksgiving weekend. IUPUI and Elon will be playing next in the championship game. UNLV wrapping things up as they'll get ready for the Mountain West opener against Fresno State. Then they'll be on the road for the next few weeks. While St. John's trying to get back in the win column, 4-2 on the season, UNLV 1-4. As UNLV transitions into a zone, the big question, can St. John's get on track shooting? A great three-point team, but they've been just 2 of 12 from outside today, and that battle has certainly been won by UNLV, Amy, who came in the best team in the Mountain West and top five in the country in opposing three-point shooting entering this weekend.
Yeah, first half, what St. John's had going for them was getting to the free throw line, even though they weren't making shots. And this half, we haven't seen them at the free throw line very often, and now UNLV has a lead. So definitely has something to do with it.
Lady Rebels closed the quarter on a 6-0 run of it, 4 of their last 5 field goals. It'll be interesting to see the rotations down the stretch with such a young team, UNLV. They really have struggled in tight games, 3 losses of 6 points or less. Wade going back to work, but she can't hit. Isis Bay the rebound, and then got grabbed on the inside as she tried to outlet it back out. And a foul coming on St. John's, 39 seconds into the fourth quarter. Waiting to see who they credit that foul to. And it will be Emma Nolan. As we look at some of the foul trouble, 4 on Nolan, 3 on Holmberg, and Sophia Nolan, the twin sister of Emma. This one blocked. Emma Nolan took it right away from Wade. And the Red Storm looked to run. England gets it to go with a foul. Will that be the spark St. John's was looking for? As Smith picks up her 4th foul in the process.
Yeah, if UNLV wants to maintain this lead, they can't let plays like this down their momentum. They have to keep it going.
So we mentioned the players in foul trouble for St. John's. UNLV, Smith with 4, Brown, Thomas, and Etheridge all with 3. With Tiana England at the line. I mentioned how she was the Nancy Lieberman Award preseason watch list, just 1 of 20 in the country. Only the 2nd player in St. John's team history to be on that list. The only other one, Nadira McKenneth, ended up playing in the WNBA, all-time leader in assists for the program. Here's another turnover. Layup, too strong for Alston, but she gets it back, misses again. Wade had it taken away a moment ago, but now able to corral the board. Her 6th of the afternoon, Wade with a season-high 16 points today. While Leilani Correa leading St. John's with 16 on the other side. Etheridge for 3. In and out, rebound to Emma Nolan of St. John's. 60-56 UNLV, 8:30 to go in the game. As it's dribbled out of bounds by Alston.
Surprisingly, that last play was Etheridge's first 3-point attempt, if I'm not mistaken, of the game. Which we usually see her shooting a lot more threes.
Yeah, you're right. 7 points today for Etheridge. Was 0-6 from beyond the arc yesterday. The coaches do love the confidence she has that she is a shooter. She'll keep shooting even when they're not falling, but at a certain point, you got to be smart.
Yeah, and I think that's what she's doing this game is getting to the basket a little bit more than shooting threes, being 0-6 last game, even though I don't think she's lost her confidence by any means. Right there going to the line, I mean going to the basket.
No call there. Both players crashing into each other. Probably a good no call, but Etheridge unable to hit. England looking to swing a pass into the paint for Bailey, but threw it right to Thomas of UNLV. Lady Rebels still up 4, just over 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. 60-56 from the Cox Pavilion. Lady Rebels' season high was 68 in their overtime loss at Southern Utah last week. Bay with the passing outside. Brown short on a 3 and a rebound to Bailey. St. John's looks to push. Alston down the other end gets the finger roll to go. It's a 2-point game with 7:25 to go in the fourth quarter. 60-58. St. John's will get a delay of game warning. As Alston now has 8 points, 7 boards to lead the way for the Red Storm, who have been very balanced. All five of their starters last year, Amy, averaged over 10 points a game.
Yeah, that's always nice when you have the balanced scoring from everyone, because you can stop one person, but another couple people are still going to get their points in.
St. John's back to his zone look. Spin move for Anna Blount. She gets blocked, though, by Kadasia Bailey, who's been a great defender for St. John's, the sophomore preseason Big East Freshman of the Year when she came in last season. England can't get the finish. Went right for the hoop instead of using the glass on an awkward angle. And UNLV keeps its 2-point edge, 6:40 to go. This pass unable to be corralled on the right block by Blount. As Jackman comes back in, she was limping a little bit earlier, was working out some kinks on the bike, and she'll come in after the timeout as St. John's and Joe Tartamella call for a timeout. It is a media timeout, so we'll step aside. 6:38 to go in the game. Good finish coming up. UNLV 60, St. John's 58. We're back with more after this here on the Mountain West Network. .638 to go from the Cox Pavilion, what's turned into a very entertaining consolation game in the Lady Rebel Roundup for 2019. UNLV up 2 on St. John's. Ben Wilson back with Amy Calloway. You always worry about some of these consolation games where teams can feel frustrated from losses the day before and that carrying over, but we haven't really seen that today. Been a very solid performance from both clubs, particularly UNLV, who have struggled so much scoring in the early going, but this has been by far their best output, at least through the first 34 minutes of the game.
Yeah, you can definitely tell both teams want to win after having a loss yesterday, so that's why we've had a pretty good game so far.
The big question is, will the experience of St. John's be the difference down the stretch? UNLV, they've been in this spot before, led against Duke in the fourth quarter. We were there at the Thomas and Mack Center a couple weeks ago, Amy. Couldn't finish then. Here's Bailey for the lead. It's good. Kadasia Bailey in the corner. And St. John's goes back on top, 61-60, with 6 minutes to play. And a foul in the backcourt. Correa a little too aggressive. Knocks into Brown. First personal on Leilani Correa. Just the third three-pointer hit today for St. John's, who went 12 of 27 from three-point range yesterday, AB. The threes were falling, and that's basketball in a nutshell. Sometimes does not carry over from day to day. Against the 2-3 zone, UNLV looks to penetrate. Inside-outside game. Thomas can't get the answer. Bailey, the rebound for St. John's. 5:35 to go. England, bounce pass into Nolan, a little too strong on the layup attempt, and it's lashed off of UNLV.
Great ball movement on the other end for UNLV. I'm trying to break down that zone for an open shot at the top, but just didn't fall.
Well, this has been multiple times now that UNLV has had to face a zone. Duke played a lot of it in the other meeting UNLV's had with a Power 5 team, and St. John's showing a bit of that as well. But the Red Storm on top here by one as we near crunch time, 5:25 to play. Correa looking to tie a career high, gets it back and scores. 18 for Leilani Correa. Brilliant afternoon for the freshman. And it's 63-60 St. John's as they've gone on a 10-0 run over the last 5.5 minutes. Can somebody step up to snap the drought for UNLV? Wade back in. Jackman passes to the wing. Brown short on the triple, but Jackman corrals the board. St. John's daring UNLV to shoot those long-range shots, something UNLV struggled with on the year. Brown again. This one banks home. Now, sooner or later, one was due to fall, and Brown ties us at 63. Into the paint goes Hoppy and draws the foul on Thomas. A little bit out of control, but Thomas wasn't totally squared up. And Quadasha Hoppy will earn a fourth foul. You're right, as Thomas and Smith each have four now for UNLV. Emma Nolan in the game right now with four fouls for St. John's and 4:28 to go.
We'll see how Thomas responds, being that she's probably the best defender on the floor for UNLV right now. But with four fouls, you can only do so much.
Nifty move there by Nolan. Playing with the four fouls, she gets inside, scored the first five of the day for St. John's. That's her first bucket since. And it's 65-63 Red Storm, 4:10 to go. Wade into the paint, doing work, and scores off the window. Rajane Wade at 2 points from tying a career high, 18 to lead the Lady Rebels today in 18 minutes. Hoppy on the wing, in and out for three. Board for Isis Bay, and then she's grabbed in the backcourt by Correa. 3:49 to go in the game. Just the second on Correa. And similar to what we've seen play out, Amy, over the last couple weeks, Isis Bay, Melanie Isbell in the rotation in crunch time, the true freshman for Kathy Olivier.
I think we're all hoping that Isbell will have one of her momentum-changing threes.
They've earned their time in that rotation, but here, in trouble, Correa forces the steal. Leilani Correa draws the foul. The pressure too much for Isbell to get past. And Kathy Olivier calls her freshman over to give her a chat, as she'll come out of the game for Caviana Brown. St. John's a chance to go back on top with Leilani Correa.
With two shots.
The length that she has makes her such a good defender and has great lateral quickness, too.
Yeah, I think every time Isabel's in, what they're using to their advantage is her height disadvantage, especially when they're pressing up like that.
Correa with a new career high, 19 points. 11 of 11 from the free throw line. They make it 12 for 12. Last year, Quadasha Hoppy set the program record, went 17 of 17 from the line in a game against Ole Miss. And Correa has been fantastic today. Her first career 20-point game to go with 7 rebounds. 67-65 St. John's. 3:35 to go as Brown streaks into the front court. Brown coast to coast. Throws one up. Wade right there. Nearly puts it in, but is fouled in the process. Wade jumping up and down. Probably thought it should have been an and one. But regardless, has a chance to tie us up again.
It's always those close, almost made field goals right after you get fouled that hurt the most, because you feel like, yeah, I would have just done a little bit differently, it would have gone down.
Have to like the aggressiveness, though, from Caviana Brown, not being afraid of that full court pressure from St. John's, just blowing right by a couple Red Storm defenders. And that's the difference right now. Isabel still kind of learning how to get into that mindset.
And Caviana's full steam ahead.
The coaches say she goes 100 miles per hour. It's one speed. Wade misses both free throws, but Bay is right there for the offensive board. Isis Bay, her second bucket today. England on the other end gets past everybody. 69-67 St. John's. England with 11 today and breezed past everybody for UNLV. One of those learning moments maybe for Bay. A great finish, but didn't get back. Yeah. Letitia Smith back in. She plays with four personals. Bailey Thomas also into the game with four for UNLV. Another close game for UNLV inside the Cox Pavilion. Down by two, Wade at the free throw line. Nice post move, and Wade goes with a follow through after she knocks it in off the glass. Tied at 69, 2:40 to go. And that ties the career high, 20.7 boards for Rajanae Wade. On the back door, Correa can't hit. Knocked around, lashed off of Bailey. Oh, beautiful play design there, Amy. St. John's has used the back door a couple times. Correa trying to put it in one motion and just didn't get the timing right.
Yeah, you got to watch that baseline. Any baseline action in that 2-3 zone is lethal sometimes.
Thomas breaks the pressure as UNLV gets it into the front court. Tied at 69, 2:10 to go. 1-4 UNLV looking for a big win to get some momentum while St. John's trying to right the ship at 4-2 after a loss yesterday. Smith thought about the three, puts it on the deck, leaves it short. Wade nearly over the back, but smartly lays off as Nolan had that rebound the whole way. 1:50 to go, tied at 69. England with the push off, and she gets called for it. Brown sells it a little bit, but Tiana England a little overzealous on that drive. The third personal on England. And now St. John's will be over the limit, so any fouls for them puts UNLV at the line going forward.
I think what I've been really impressed with this season for UNLV is how many people are able to take charges. I think Coach Collier on UNLV has always emphasized that years. And not many people can do that, and it's fun to see all of them being able to.
Poked away by Correa. That was a beautiful backdoor look. That's where being a 6-foot guard comes in handy. If you're a couple inches shorter, that's an easy lay-in for Bailey Thomas. And UNLV resets. 14 on the shot clock, 1:23 to play. All knotted up at 69. Brown throws one up, too strong off the glass, and Correa, another rebound. Her eighth today. Correa glides to the basket, too strong, but a foul called, and it's a charge on the St. John's freshman. Joe Tardamella can't believe it, wants an explanation. But right on cue, like you were just talking about, Amy, in transition against the speedster Correa, UNLV draws the charge.
Being able to set yourself up in transition to take a charge is probably one of the hardest things to do. And like I said, UNLV's shown everyone can do it.
Knocked out of bounds by Emma Nolan. 1:03 to play, tied at 69. St. John's this season, 1-2 in games decided by single digits. As Smith has it in the corner, UNLV in close games have gotten stagnant in the past offensively. We'll see what they do here. Lob for Wade, and a double team, and travels. Smart defense as Alston collapsed down low along with Nolan. Back to St. John's with 53.4 to go, tied at 69. And a timeout taken by St. John's. Both teams now with two remaining, and that's one of those defensive plays, Amy, we saw yesterday opposing teams going with on RJ Wade, especially once she burns you a couple times.
Especially in crunch time, I think UNLV is going to look for RJ in the post, so they did a really smart job on that last play, making sure that she didn't get it.
Now, both teams have not scored over the past couple minutes. Leilani Correa has been huge today with leading scorer Quidasha Hoppy struggling, just 5 points in 34 minutes, but Correa's picked up the slack, 20 points, a career high, 8 boards for the second straight game, tying a season high, while Bailey has hit 4 of her last 5 shots, And Tiana England has chipped in with 11 off the bench. So three in double figures for St. John's. Wade with a career day, tying a career high with 20 points, 7 rebounds. Krista Jackman, 8 boards off the bench for Kathy Olivier. The one thing that plays into UNLV's favor here, only 3 team fouls. We saw St. John's attack the rack early and often, 24 of 27 from the line today. Are you anticipating that's the same thing they'll be doing here, Amy, now in the final couple possessions, if you're looking at this from a Red Storm perspective, trying to, again, crash the glass and get inside? Are you more looking for the outside three ball with how lethal your shooters have been in the past?
I think you got to go with what you're good with. I think they're going to try to get to the line and just finish up the free throw line. They haven't really been shooting much or hitting much on the floor, so I definitely would go to what you're good at.
Yeah, a great three-point shooting team on the season, but struggling today, just 3 of 14. As we're tied at 69 out of the timeout, 45 seconds to play, and a 23-second differential. England penetrates, lobbing for Hoppy, as St. John's will work clock. Hoppy double-teamed, gets it away. Bailey into the paint. Tough runner is good off the glass with 30 seconds to go. And a timeout, UNLV. Tough finish in the paint for Bailey. And the Red Storm take a 2-point advantage, 71-69.
Those types of plays definitely have to hurt because UNLV was very active in that zone right there. There wasn't really anything I could say about that defense, and then just Bailey just finished really well right there.
You have to be impressed with Bailey, who was had to grow up in a hurry. She was the only freshman on the team last year, but was still on the All-Big East freshman team. And has seen her role really increase even more this season, playing almost 27 minutes a game, leads the way in field goal percentage. And has shown a lot of control for an underclassman, 13 points, 7 boards, and 6 of 9 from the field.
Yeah, she's hit. You said last time you mentioned it was 4 out of the last 5, now it's 5 of the last 6, so she's been really efficient in the last couple minutes.
So what do you do now if you're UNLV? You'd imagine run something toward the basket with Wade, knowing, though, that she'll likely draw a double team.
You also have Bay on the floor, who, although she hasn't really been, like, really well scoring-wise, like 2, 3, 4 points here and there, but she's really been efficient. She's finished what she's gotten.
We'll see what UNLV does. 20 seconds to go. Game and shot clock essentially even. St. John's up 71-69. Smith on the drive. Can't hit. Wade hit the underside of the rim. Comes back to Smith, and she puts it in. Tie game at 71. 11.8 to go. And St. John's calls timeout. What a sequence as Wade maybe lost track of where she was under the basket, but a fortunate carom comes right to Letitia Smith. And the redshirt senior, who's played against St. John's a couple times in the past when she was at Seton Hall, has 11 points and 5 boards today.
What's nice to see is it's crunch time, but you don't see any drop-off in energy. You have 3 shots going up, but all these offensive rebounds ends up getting that last one to fall.
UNLV does have a foul to give. Both teams with 1 timeout. Smith and Bailey Thomas on the floor with 4 personals for UNLV. Emma Nolan with 4 for St. John. So we saw good defensive possession out of UNLV on the last sequence, but St. John's was just too good. You would assume a similar type setup here, Amy.
We'll see if UNLV can keep up that good moving zone, but just make it a little bit harder to shoot.
11.8 to go. Tied at 71. St. John's is Nolan with the ball. 8 seconds to go. Caught behind the 3-point line. It's knocked away. Brown hits the deck. 2 seconds to go. 1 now showing, and time will expire as we head to overtime. Kaviana Brown knocked it away from Tiana England. A huge defensive play. And the Lady Rebels head to overtime for the 2nd time in the last 4 games.
Amazing hustle there by Kaviana Brown, too. She tries to get the steal, is on the floor, gets up to run to try to get the ball again. Didn't just stop when she hit the floor.
What a finish inside Cox Pavilion. as St. John's and UNLV battling all day. Tied at 71 as we go to overtime. We'll get a short break to collect ourselves and come back for the five-minute extra session here on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube. Five more minutes of basketball coming up inside Cox Pavilion as UNLV and St. John's deadlocked at 71. A fun way to wrap up what's been a very busy Thanksgiving weekend throughout all college athletics as we return to Las Vegas. Ben Wilson alongside Amy Calloway. UNLV has struggled this year in those late game situations, Amy, but you have to be impressed with how a young team has improved in that regard. And they played with a lot of poise and confidence in those final couple possessions, really frustrating St. John's on the Red Storm's offensive side of the ball.
Yeah, I think even though you can say UNLV has improved on those fourth quarter overtime performances, it's nice that they're in those positions as well as the young team.
UNLV fell in overtime at Southern Utah, 72-68 in Cedar City a couple weeks ago. First overtime game of the year for St. John's, who come in 4-2. UNLV 1-4. And 1-3 at home. Rajne Wade tying a career high with 20 points today. She and Krista Jackman with 8 rebounds. Letitia Smith also in double figures with 11 for UNLV, while Leilani Correa, a new season high for the freshman with 20 points to pace St. John's. So here we go. Overtime underway from inside Cox Pavilion. Knotted up at 71. St. John's over the limit foul-wise, while UNLV still does have one to give. Brown picks up her dribble. So does Smith as she hands back for Bailey Thomas on the first possession of overtime. 3 on the shot clock. Brown just has to throw one up. Hits glass and then falls right to Emma Nolan, who's on the floor with 4 fouls for St. John's. The scoop won't go, but a foul as Alston got in between Isis Bay and Letitia Smith. Alyssa Alston, the former starter at Ole Miss, now playing closer to home, the New Haven, Connecticut native. Played 86 career games at Ole Miss before transferring, and in her 6th start of the year, averaging about 11 per game. 80% at the line is Alyssa Alston. And makes the first. 25 of 28 from the free throw line today for St. John's, as Alston can become the 4th Red Storm player in double figures with a make here. In and out, and Wade gets the board for UNLV. 72-71 St. John's. Lady Rebels look to push. Smith into the paint, draws contact. And that, if it's on Emma Nolan, is her 5th. And that is the case. So Emma Nolan, a starter, fouls out. 7 points, 5 rebounds in 18 minutes for the 6'1 freshman. So with Alicia Cabey already out injured, did not play today, the senior starter for St. John's, Nolan, the replacement starter, is out. And St. John's has to sub. And they're trying to figure out who to bring in. Kodasha Hoppy already on the floor. And it will be Kadesia Bailey who comes back in. So a St. John's team that usually goes small to begin with loses one of its couple post players. Bailey's really the other who gets significant minutes. And she sits in on the left block next to Isis Bay.
Yeah, we'll see if UNLV can take advantage of the size inside.
Letitia Smith hits the first. You give credit to Letitia. Shot hasn't fallen all weekend. 2 of 12 yesterday, 5 of 18 today, but she's kept with it. And now has 13 points, her first trip to the line in 25 minutes, playing the last few with 4 personal fouls. Will Bailey continue to be the hot hand? She's hit 5 of her last 6 for St. John's, but it's UNLV by 1. 73-72. Correa for 3. It's off the mark. Smith the rebound for UNLV. Couldn't ask for a better look there if you're the Red Storm. Especially with how hot Correa has been all day today. Some ball pressure on Brown. St. John's continuing to sag off, daring UNLV, who's been 4 of 15 from deep, to launch the triple. 5 on the shot clock. Smith the penetration. Step back, cold-blooded, is good from the left elbow. And then almost taken away by Bailey Thomas on the inbounds. 75-72 UNLV. That is smooth from the senior nicknamed TT. With 3:25 to go in overtime. That's confidence, Amy, that we might not have seen even a couple weeks ago out of Letitia Smith.
Well, I mean, last game she had 5 points, but 2 games before that she had 2 20-point games, so I think she's just trying to get back to those 20-point game performances.
And that is a charge called on Quadasha Hoppe. Big call there, as Hoppe arguing that the UNLV defender, I believe that was Isis Bay who drew the charge, was in the restricted area. And Joe Tardamella asking for a review, but they will not give it to him with 3:10 to go. Officials saying that it was clear and obvious, so no need to review. And UNLV with the big advantage, at least in the first 2 minutes of overtime, up by 3. Smith, double clutch, tough shot, hits the bottom of the backboard and takes a long carom out to Tiana England. England all the way draws a foul as Brown picks it up. And Brown now the third Lady Rebel to pick up 4 fouls. And 2:46 to play. But assistant coach, a couple of the assistant coaches, Amy, were telling me at practice the other day that for Smith, they really worked hard with her on her follow-through. She was coming up short on a lot of shots, and ever since she made that adjustment, like you mentioned, 20 points in the previous 2 games before this weekend, and her confidence has just skyrocketed ever since.
I think the coaches all know that Letitia Smith has the potential to be a really, really good scorer, so just working on the things in practice that have hindered her in the last couple games, I think, has definitely paid off.
England goes 1 of 2. Smith did average almost 9 a game as a starter at Seton Hall before she transferred. UNLV breaks the press. Rajane Wade fumbles it and loses it out of bounds. UNLV trying to go quick after breaking the press, and Wade couldn't quite keep it in her grasp. 2:39 to play. UNLV still on top, 75-73, but it's back to St. John's. Both Elon and IUPUI, their teams looking on. Championship game to follow this one. Bailey has hit 5 of her last 6. Drives and kicks. Correa open for 3. That's short. And Wade comes up with the rebound. Another double-double for RJ Wade. 20-10 today. Bay gets the entry. Goes baby hook but can't finish. Fight for the board. It looked like Bay knocked that off the knee of Tiana England. Really smart play by Bay, who had the presence of mind on the ground just to shovel that off of Tiana England.
And if I'm not mistaken, that's probably, I think, the first miss that we've seen from Bay, and she definitely recovered the ball really well there.
You are right. First miss of the day, 5 points, 7 boards off the bench for the freshman. Brown a little too strong. Wade with those long arms sucks it in. Never hit the rim, though, so the shot clock doesn't reset. Brown throws that over the backboard, and that will be out of bounds. Kathy Olivier asking for a review, as that did not hit the baseline, but instead went over the corner of the backboard. 1:50 to go. 75-73, UNLV leads in overtime. And they will not change the call. Well, if the ball goes over the backboard, that's supposed to be out of play. And Olivier arguing based on the angle, it didn't actually go out of bounds. But I think, Amy, that's the right call since it went over the backboard.
Yeah, I think as a coach in these tight games, you're going to try to get as many
right.
as you can, regardless of whether you think it's correct or not.
But no matter, on the other end, a turnover, and then Bay drops it in, powering her way into the paint, gets position on Bailey, and UNLV leads by 4 in overtime. 1:20 to go, forcing the 19th turnover for St. John's on that last possession.
Great positioning by Bay right there, and great finish, especially by a freshman. Like I said, she's been one of the more efficient ones, even though she hasn't gotten the ball very often. She does what she needs to, and she gets it.
And UNLV earns the jump ball. Possession arrow keeps it with St. John's. 9 on the shot clock, 1:06 to go. Well, against the zone of UNLV, St. John's has not been able to figure out a way to get their clean looks to drop. They've gotten clean looks, but 3 of 16 from the outside today and just 36% overall. 3 on the shot clock, dribbled off the foot of Correa, and UNLV brings it in. 55 seconds to go. And a bucket here might ice the game for the Lady Rebels. Desperate for a win at 1-4.
You see KO telling him, be smart with the ball, run the clock out, get as much time off the clock as possible, be patient, and just don't do anything rash.
Brown on the drive. Caviana Brown too strong. Ball comes to Alston. St. John's down 4. 30 seconds to go. Into the front court. Too strong is Hoppy. Follow-up misses by Alston. Gets it back and is fouled by Isis Bay. 3 looks at the basket from close range, and St. John's gets to the line with 26.8 to go. The second personal on Isis Bay. So you're in the spot now for St. John's. You would think, assuming Alston hits these free throws, you'll try to get the trap in the backcourt, and as soon as UNLV crosses the timeline, that's when you go with the foul, right?
I'd assume so. St. John's has been pretty smart here, and they've obviously...
Because they forced several backcourt turnovers today out of UNLV.
We'll see how UNLV responds to what I'm assuming the pressure that St. John's is going to put on them after this free throw.
Alston, an 80% foul shooter, hits both. A calm stroke from the redshirt senior, Alyssa Alston, playing in her 92nd career collegiate game today. And with 26.8 to go, UNLV takes time. 1 left for the Lady Rebels. Both teams over the limit as St. John's has 2 timeouts to work with. UNLV 77, St. John's 75 in overtime in the consolation game of the 2019 Lady Rebel Roundup. You have to say, Amy, UNLV, they've handled these pressure moments today really well, much better than they have in the early going of this year.
Yeah,
a young team trying to grow up on the fly.
Yeah, I think KO took this time out just to make sure to let them know, like, St. John's is going to pressure. We need to stay level-headed, get the ball over the half-court line, and be smart with this last possession.
As we reset things, Nolan has already fouled out for St. John's with the 5 personals. Nobody else has 4. While Smith, Brown, and Thomas all with 4 personals for UNLV. And in talking with the UNLV coaching staff, they knew that a couple of those early losses really hurt them, because the loss to Fullerton, the loss to Southern Utah, all chances to get positive momentum and energy for a young team in need of some confidence. But this would certainly go a long way. As we talked about on our open, Tuesday is the Mountain West opener against Fresno State when the games really count. And UNLV 26.8 seconds away from getting a huge upset win over the preseason pick in St. John's to finish 2nd in the 10-team Big East. Still a long way to go, though. St. John's without one of its leading scorers, Alicia Cabey, out injured this weekend, and Nolan has fouled out. We'll see what Joe Tartamella also draws up defensively. But you've seen and been impressed, Amy, with how both Letitia Smith and Caviana Brown, who's ever been on the ball, they've handled that backcourt pressure really well today.
Yeah, they have. They definitely broke it super easy going straight down the middle, or just going at a faster pace than the defense is allowed to set up.
Melissa Alston with a double-double today, 11 points. A St. John's career high, 10 rebounds in her first season playing for the Red Storm. And that's a career high across all levels for Alston today in 33 minutes today. Despite an off shooting game for Quadasha Hoppy, just 5 points in 39 minutes. She's played almost the whole game, just 1 of 8 shooting. But despite that, St. John's has used its great shooting at the foul line to stay in this game. 28 of 32 today. And UNLV, who has struggled in that area this season, although better today, 15 of 21, will have to make its throws and avoid a turnover here down the stretch in this at least immediate possession out of the timeout. So both teams get ready to break the huddle. 26.8 to go in this overtime period. UNLV 77, St. John 75. This has been by far the most points the Lady Rebels have scored this year after putting up just 44 yesterday and a 50-44 loss to Elon on 32% shooting. So here we go. Both teams coming out of the timeout. These are the games you obviously will cause stress if you're a head coach, Jamie, but you also love to see them for your young players. Forces them to grow up in a hurry. And UNLV now, all but one of their games this season has been decided by single digits. And the Duke game that was a 12-point loss was basically tied until the last 2 minutes.
Yeah, and if you're UNLV right now, you just hope that you've learned from those past couple games and you kind of come out with the win here by being even-keeled, not letting the pressure get to you, and hopefully making this last possession of the game.
So we had a review during that timeout. I'm not sure what the discussion was because we just had 2 free throws and a timeout. I think the discussion is UNLV advancing to the front court, but that's usually automatic when you take a timeout after a made free throw. I'm guessing maybe, Amy, the only question could be, did Kathy Olivier wait too long to call the timeout? But that's usually not an issue. Officials have been pretty lenient on that, granting the team the front court inbounds. And that's been a rule change, too. It used to always be you'd still have the baseline inbounds, but they followed the NBA's lead on that, the college game. And
yeah, it looks like the refs are staying consistent and
yeah,
allowing that advance.
And also to UNLV's number 24, Rajane Wade.
So it looks like we actually had after all that, I didn't even see it, but a double tech called on Alyssa Alston and Rajane Wade. Must have been as the two teams were walking toward their bench. Didn't really look like anything physical or anything was really said. Here, almost into the backcourt is Letitia Smith, as St. John's thought they might have gotten an over and back. That was really close. And Correa grabs Smith for her 4th personal. From our vantage point, we're right at half court. I thought, Amy, Smith touched that ball before she went into the backcourt. And
yeah,
St. John's,
right, see that contact.
At the very least, that was a little bit too close for comfort if you're Kathy Olivier and UNLV. But Smith steps to the line now where she has led the team in free throw shooting. Led last year at 89%, so this is who you want at the line. 2 for 2 today. And goes in and out on the first free throw. 22.7 to go in overtime. UNLV up 77-75. That double tech, by the way, put Wade with 3 personals, Alston with 3 personals as well during the timeout. And Smith gets the second. 78-75. UNLV and St. John's now takes time. A 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here on the Mountain West Network and streaming live on YouTube with 22.7 to go. I have to admit, Amy, I'm a little surprised that, and of course, officials want to make sure the game stays under control and everything, but to give a double tech, we're our position. We're normally courtside, but we're up top here at the Cox Pavilion. I am a little surprised to see them give a double tech on something that did look pretty minor at this stage in the game, a one-possession game in overtime.
Especially when we didn't even notice.
And, yeah, neither coach really noticed either. Must have just been something that one of the officials heard as the two were walking by each other. But regardless, really no harm, no foul for either, as neither, luckily for their sake, was in significant foul trouble. And now what do you do if you're St. John's? Do you go for the quick two or look for the 3 point and the tie? Still a lot of time left, 22.7, as the Red Storm inbound, nearly stolen by Bailey Thomas. 18.4 to go. Each team with one timeout, both teams over the limit, and we'll be in bonus free throw territory on either of the two's next foul. 78-75 UNLV in what's been a great battle this afternoon. St. John's ball down three. England, the redshirt junior, backs into the paint, puts one up, off to the side, and Wade gets the rebound. 9.7 to go. And Rajanay Wade, already with a career day, will look to extend the Lady Rebels' lead and put this game on ice. What did you think about the play call there? England, pretty good look in the paint, but just a little off balance on that mid-paint shot.
I'm sure England was probably hoping that she'd get the foul there and end up at the free throw line like they've been doing so well in this whole game. But luckily, UNLV was smart and did not foul.
And they really backed off, but Wade comes up short on the first free throw. Rajanay Wade, 6 of 11 at the line today. Each team with one timeout. 78-75 UNLV, a massive free throw here for the 6'2 senior, Rajanay Wade. She got it. 79-75. And now the Red Storm will take their final timeout to advance the ball into the front court. So Wade, who is, like we talked about, Amy, worked so hard on her free throw shooting, was just 42% as a freshman, but has gotten that stroke much better. And got the important one, got one to make it a two-score game.
Yeah, free throws can be one of those, they're free, but it's different practicing. I know KO as a coach, she's always harping on free throws. When I was a player, we either made 50 or shot 50 and told and reported how many we got out of 50 or how many it took to make 50. So, but it's different in practice. When you're in games like this, when it's crunch time, 9.7 left in such a close game, those are much different than the free throws you practice.
You're exactly right. And it's a four-point game now. You go back to some of the key topics we talked about early on. UNLV, the best rebounding team in the conference, out-rebounding St. John's by 9 today, improving on their already conference-best 6 differential. Best three-point defensive team in the conference, UNLV. St. John's just 3 of 16 from outside. That's been the difference, as Smith knocks it away. And right now with 8.1, you need something probably within the next 3 to 4 seconds. Quickly into the corner, inside to Hoppy. That layup won't go. Hoppy gets it back, misses again. Wade the rebound, and that will do it. UNLV comes back, then survives in overtime. As the Lady Rebels get their second win of the year, a hard-fought, emotional 79-75 win in overtime over St. John's. Not a bad game for you to return to, Amy.
I think I was a good luck charm. Me and all my Thanksgiving food still being digested.
There you go. As far as what we saw down the stretch, Rajanay Wade, who only played a couple minutes in the first half, 21 points, 13 rebounds, now 4 double-doubles in the season's first 6 games. The leadership the senior has showed, you kind of assume that any player going from junior to senior being that leader will take place, but it really has been a great impact for Rajanay. It's not always automatic that you see that leadership come.
Yeah, it's great that she was on the bench almost the entire first half and still comes out making up for lost time and getting that career high game.
St. John's, certainly better days ahead. Just a tough shooting day for an already shorthanded team as they fall by 4. But going into conference play for UNLV, what does that do, Amy? I mean, I feel like it's hard to emphasize enough for a team that is so young, that has struggled so much shooting in the early season, to get a win like this over a Power 5 team with Fresno State coming in on Tuesday.
Getting a win over a Power 5 team, but not only that, but a team that's supposed to be doing really well this year and finishing off in their conference really well. So going into conference with this win is definitely great for UNLV, and I hope they can use this momentum to get a couple wins under their belt early.
So again, our final score, UNLV 79, St. John 75 in overtime. Thanks so much for joining us on this Thanksgiving weekend, Sunday. As for Amy Calloway, I'm Ben Wilson saying so long. The Lady Rebels go to 2-4. St. John's drops to 4-3. This has been a presentation of the Mountain West Network, streaming live on YouTube.